If you want to find a solution to an inhomogeneous system of linear ODEs like this one, written here in vector notation, then the superposition principle suggests that a good strategy is to find a particular solution of that differential equation and then a general solution to the corresponding homogeneous differential equation, and then combining these two solutions in order to get a general solution to the inhomogeneous system. So the first step is to find a particular solution of the inhomogeneous system. Since we just need one single solution, you can be opportunistic here and just try to find the simplest one. Now the simplest one, if it exists, is a constant solution. Because when looking for a constant solution, so a solution that does not depend on time, the time derivative vanishes and the differential equation simplifies to this one, because the time derivative, so y dot, disappears. Now this equation, if A is invertible, can simply be rearranged this way. So we multiply A inverse on both sides, and we have immediately a constant solution to the inhomogeneous system. Once we have this solution yic, and still assuming A is invertible, we can rearrange our original differential equation in the following way. So we multiply B by A inverse, and then we can write A as a common factor in front of yi minus A inverse B. Since A inverse B is yic, we can then write this as A times yi of t minus yic. Written this way, we can easily see that yic is a constant solution to this inhomogeneous differential equation. Because if we replace yi by yic, the right side becomes zero, and then the derivative is zero, and we get a constant solution. So this is a valid solution. Written this way, this differential equation also illustrates nicely the first statement of the superposition principle. If we have a solution of the homogeneous differential equation, and we add and subtract yic, then we can align this with a inhomogeneous differential equation by defining yi as a sum of yh plus yic. Since yic is a constant, the time derivative of yi and yh does not differ. The top one is the inhomogeneous differential equation, the bottom one is the homogeneous one, and the inhomogeneous solution, so yi, is simply the sum of yh, so the general solution of the homogeneous differential equation, plus the particular solution of the inhomogeneous differential equation yic. As an example, consider this inhomogeneous differential equation. Yi dot equals the matrix 1, 1, 4, 1 times yi minus 1, 1. In order to find a particular solution of this inhomogeneous differential equation, we first need the inverse of A. I compute this here in a very simple way by simply setting the product between the inverse with the matrix A to the identity matrix. This leads to a system of linear equations which can be easily solved. I leave this to you as an exercise, and the result is the inverse that you see here. It is easy to verify that A inverse actually is the inverse of A by multiplying it with A, which results in the identity matrix. Once we have the inverse, we can simply calculate the constant solution by multiplying it with B. And the resulting vector is 0, 1. The time derivative, of course, is a zero vector because we have a constant solution. Finally, we verify that yic is a solution of our differential equation by inserting it. So this is our original differential equation. We insert yi that we have found, namely 0, 1, and the derivative is 0, 0. And then it is easy to calculate that the matrix times this vector is 1, 1. 1, 1 minus 1, 1 is 0. So we have found a constant solution of our inhomogeneous differential equation. This was the first step. The second step is to find a general solution of the homogeneous system. When we use the ansatz that yh equals a times exponential lambda t, and following from that, the derivative would be lambda times a times the exponential of lambda t, then from our homogeneous differential equation, it follows that lambda a exponential lambda t equals matrix a times a exponential lambda t. And if we then divide by exponential of lambda t, which we can always do because that is strictly positive, we get this equation, which is an eigenvalue equation. Thus, once we have found eigenvectors and eigenvalues of our matrix, the solutions are simply the eigenvector times the exponential of the eigenvalue times t. And because of the superposition principle, we simply have to combine these solutions. If A is an n by n matrix, then there are typically n linearly independent solutions. And hopefully, one can get them by finding n eigenvectors. That's not always the case, but that's the easiest. Let us go back to our example. The homogeneous ODE that belongs to the inhomogeneous one that we've considered is this. The corresponding eigenvalue problem is this. So matrix times vector equals eigenvalue times vector. And we need to find A and lambda. And since this is a 2x2 matrix, we definitely find two eigenvalues and hope to find two eigenvectors. We can rearrange this equation and find that a non-trivial solution for A is only possible if the determinant of the matrix, which is a characteristic polynomial, vanishes. If matrix 1 minus lambda, 1, 4, 1 minus lambda would be invertible, so the determinant would not be 0, then A would have to be 0 in order to fulfill this equation. So we need somehow to choose the lambda such that the determinant vanishes. And that is the way to figure out the lambdas. So we set the determinant to 0, and the determinant in this case is 1 minus lambda squared minus 4. Now this is easy enough to see that the values 3 and minus 1 would solve this. Because 1 minus lambda squared minus 4 equals 0 requires that 1 minus lambda squared is 4. That means 1 minus lambda can be either plus 2 or minus 2, and that leads to one lambda value being 3 and the other one being 1. With the known eigenvalues, we can now determine the eigenvectors. So we insert the eigenvalues in our eigenvalue equation. So remember, this equation is a rearranged version of A times A1 equals lambda 1 A1. We've simply moved lambda 1 A1 to the left side and have integrated this into this matrix 1 minus lambda 1, 1, 4, 1 minus lambda 1. For lambda 1 equals 3, we get this result. And now it's interesting that the rows of the matrix are linearly dependent, so one is just a scaled version of the other one. Actually, the bottom one is minus 2 times the top one, and that is by construction, right? Remember, we have chosen lambda such that the determinant of this matrix is 0, and that for a 2x2 matrix means that the rows and columns are linearly dependent. So in order to figure out A1, we only have to consider one of the rows. Let's pick the top one. Once we have that, it's easy to see that a possible solution is A equals 1, 2. Please note that the reasoning goes here from bottom to top, even though we have worked our way from top to bottom, because we just have to find a solution to the equation. So if A is 1, 2, then equation 63 is true. But it does not follow from 63 that A is 1, 2. A being 2, 4 would be fine as well, right? So any scaled version would also be an eigenvector, right? So we work our way from top to bottom, but the actual reasoning is from bottom to top. In a similar way, one can figure out a second eigenvector, and I've picked here 1 minus 2. So now that we have the eigenvectors and eigenvalues, we can combine the general solution of the homogeneous system by simply combining the solutions, each of which consists of the eigenvector times the exponential times the eigenvalue times t, and inserting the values that we have found above, we get c1 times the vector 1, 2 exponential 3t plus c2 times the vector 1, minus 2 times exponential of minus t. The third step now is to combine the particular solution of the inhomogeneous system with the general solution of the homogeneous one. And that generates the general solution of the inhomogeneous differential equation. In general, this is simply A inverse B plus the combination of all the solutions that we have found for the homogeneous system, each one with an arbitrary prefactor Ci. For our example, this would yield 0, 1 plus c1 vector 1, 2 exponential 3t plus c2 vector 1, minus 2 exponential minus t. Please note that this general solution has two free parameters, and this corresponds to the 2x2 matrix, or the two equations that we had and the two functions. So now let us verify that the solution that we have found is indeed a solution of our inhomogeneous differential equation. Remember, this was our inhomogeneous differential equation. Now we plug in our solution and the derivative. This is the derivative. This is a solution. Next, we rearrange all the terms, so we move them all to the right side and group them by the exponential function. So we group all terms that have a common prefactor c1 exponential 3t and c2 exponential minus t, and those that don't have such a prefactor. And then we simply have to calculate the matrix vector products and see that these all cancel out, and we get a 0 in the end, which equals 0, so it's a true statement. So the solution that we have found is indeed a solution of our inhomogeneous system of ODEs. From the solution that we have found, all the interesting dynamics is contained in the terms that come from the solution of the homogeneous differential equation. The particular solution of the inhomogeneous differential equation is just a constant. So in the following, we will focus just on the analysis of the homogeneous differential equation, because that's the interesting part. And a solution to the inhomogeneous differential equation can simply be produced by adding this constant vector.